Welcome back, everybody, to another dicondissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today we're going to be reacting to Moonlight Mile by the Rolling Stones. It's been a minute since we've done a Stones song. I'm very excited to check this out. Such a great group. Thank you very much for joining me. If you are new to the channel, welcome. My name is Daniel, and here we react to music, and I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally, and we do some research on the artists and what they intended with their songs and their masterpieces. This is really fun, so thank you for watching. I didn't really expect anyone to when I started doing this, and I've just been thinking a little bit about that recently. I just once again want to say thank you. And thank you to the person who requested this under one of my Rolling Stones videos. Moonlight Mile. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. That's beautiful. That's awesome. I guess I should pause it one time. This is beautiful. Love the, the panning. The mix is very cool. And that guitar coming in right there just now, the like kind of soft electric guitar, that was perfect. Let's keep going. Drumming's really cool here.
Come on up, let it go now. Yeah, let it go now. Yeah. Flow down, baby. Yeah, roll down.
boys. Only one person requested this. As far maybe other people have, but when I checked, I saw a bunch of top comments for a bunch of other songs. Then a little farther down, someone said this is a super underrated Stone song, and I wanted to check it out. And that like riff, just another moonlight, my like da 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 da, super catchy, and takes the verse to like a whole nother level. Yeah, man, what a beautiful song. I love it. This is off the album Sticky Fingers. Let's see. Oh, it's the finale to the album, the closer. Underrated and timeless. Peak Stones. Oh, damn. I have cancer thanks to Sister Morphine. I am not suffering from indescribable pain. I listen to the song and I forget the trance that I'm going through. In total, I have little time left on this earth. I do not suffer for me. I suffer for my family and my best friends. We all lose out. It's that hard and crude. I am young. I am 64 years old. I have lived life with intensity. I cannot complain about anything. Life has treated me with great generosity. Thank you all. Alex. 2019. I think this is this band's greatest achievement. Pure brilliance never gets old. Dang. My younger brother was learning the song on his guitar. The other day when I made his headstone, I included the inscription, "Home is just about a moonlight mile on down the road." We laid him to rest at a small country cemetery with the rest of the family. About a mile on down the road from our home place where us four boys were raised. Rest in peace. These are sad. To all the young intrepids who set out with big dreams but never made it home. Rest in peace, Mr. Watts. Your drumming on this track is phenomenal. Yes, rest in peace. All right, let's... forgot to bring it up on Genius, so let's do that now. So that we can do a little bit of research. Oh, there was a movie called Moonlight Mile as well. One of the more poetic Jagger compositions, Moonlight Mile thematically expresses a train passenger's sense of solitude. The narrator's loneliness is evoked by the absence of a lover, subtly symbolized by the moonlight, untouchable, yet illuminating. In an interview with Mark Myers of the Wall Street Journal in 2015, the Stones singer said Moonlight Mile was written in a songbook I carried around when we were on tour in the summer of 1970. I was growing road-weary and homesick, and I'm sure the idea for the song first came to me one night while we were on a train and the moon was out. However, this differs markedly from what Mick told Tom Donahue, or Hugh, in 1971, where he said, "I always like to write lyrics to a song before we got into the studio, but lyrics for Moonlight Mile were not written before we cut the track. It was extemporized." Moonlight Mile was the first song that was cut without Keith Richards. Keith's absence, the reason for which can only be assumed, resulted in Mick playing acoustic guitar on the recording. What a beautiful, like, very poetic song. When the wind blows and the rain feels cold with a head full of snow, in the window... Is this a reference to... something? Alright. In the window, there's a face, you know. Doesn't the night pass slow? First he says night, then he says nights.
Could be referring to drawing doodles.
And faces on cars, trains, buses, etc. when it's cold. Could also be taken as a metaphor and mean the other side of the glass. There's a familiar face, but he can't communicate or get close to it since the window's in the distance. I would also say in the window there's a face where you can, you know, see your literal reflection in the window. The sound of strangers sending nothing to my mind. Just another mad, mad day on the road. And I'm just living to be lying by your side, but I'm just about a moonlight mile down the road. The fans and concert crowd, however appealing, doesn't give Mick a pleasure anymore, feeling more like another day at work. In fact, he only yearns for his lover who is miles away from him. The nocturnal, winterly atmosphere of the song is further expanded with the inclusion of the key word, moonlight. Made a rag pile of my shiny clothes going to warm my bones. I've got silence on my radio. Let the airwaves flow. Mick is throwing away his onstage clothes in order to wear warmer ones. Could you blame him? It is also a metaphor for getting rid of his stage persona and returning to his true self, who longs for a bit of warmth. There's also some nifty wordplay here. The shiny, warm adjectives could be taken as metaphorical description of a man who is now void of a prior infatuation with fame and fortune. I'm sleeping under strange, strange skies. My dreams are fading down the railway line, and I'm just about a moonlight mile on the road. Mick again employs the word strange to emphasize the alienation while he's away from home. Not only that, but he makes a poignant parallel between his ever-waning dreams and the way the various environments surrounding the railway line are fading in the eyes of the train traveler as the train runs through them. He is basically getting farther and farther away from his dreams as time goes on. It's a sad song. I'm hiding, sister, and I'm dreaming. I'm riding down your moonlight mile. I'm riding down your moonlight mile. Let it go now, baby. Come on up. Let it go now. The riff right here with the let it go now, and then on the one side the guitar is it's perfect. Yeah. And that's Moonlight Mile by the Rolling Stones. Thank you very much for joining me. Thank you to the people or person, whoever. Thank you to anyone who has requested this track, and thank you to anyone who's watching. I hope you're having a great week. Stay tuned for more videos. Things are going to get interesting over here, but hang tight. See you soon. Deathstroke 9.